My name is Gloria Mensa, and I am the CAFAS Training Coordinator for the Department of Behavioral Health. The CAFAS, better known as the Child and Adolescent Functional Assessment Scale, and we also do the PECFAS, which is the Preschool and Early Childhood Functional Assessment Scale. The CAFAS and PECFAS offers assistance in determining intensity of services needed, provide pre- and post-outcome measures, help providers manage cases during course of treatment, assess strengths and weaknesses to direct treatment goals, agency tracking and quality improvement, and provides a common language for treatment collaboration. It gives us data of what's going on within a 90-day time frame. Each CAFAS subscale score can range from 0 to 30, 0 for minimal impairment, 10 for mild, 20 for moderate, and 30 for severe. Total scores can range from 0 to 240. Currently in the district, the CAFAS is used to assess youth ages 6 to 20 and the PECFAS for ages 3 to 5. And with that information, service providers across the district can get together and collaborate using this tool to determine what kind of treatment plans need to be put in place. The CAFAS subscales are school and work, home, community, behavior towards others, moods and emotions, self-harmful behavior, substance use, and thinking.
The CAFAS-PECFAS assess for areas of impairment in various life domains by finding out what are the behaviors and symptoms contributing to any difficulties the youth may be experiencing. School and Work subscale focuses on the youth's behavior in school in regards to attendance, how well they are doing academically, as well as their behaviors in the classroom and/or at work. The home subscale assess for behaviors in the household that are unsafe, puts others in the home at risk of danger, or not following the rules set forth by a caregiver or caregivers. Community subscale assesses behaviors that could potentially involve law enforcement or legal issues. Delinquent behaviors that result in either diversion programs, arrest, or confinement will be rated on this subscale. Behavior towards others looks at behavior towards other individuals in multiple settings, such as in school, in the home, or in the community. This scale also takes a look at the youth's judgment that puts themselves or others at risk. The moods and emotions subscale focuses on symptoms of anxiety and depression that may be impacting the youth's functioning in different aspects of their lives. Assessing for significant mood changes can help providers intervene clinically to address the issue. For the self-harm scale, it is reserved for behaviors indicating self-harm that is non-accidental, done purposely with a desire to die, non-intentional behaviors that could result in death, mutilation, or injury, but not life-threatening. The substance use scale assesses the amount and frequency of substance use in a 90-day time frame. On this subscale, raters will score how often the youth engages in consumption of alcohol, marijuana, and other hard drugs such as cocaine, heroin, or PCP. The use of cigarettes are not rated on this scale. With the thinking scale, the goal is to note any behaviors that may be related to some severe mental health problem. On this scale, we do not rely on DSM diagnoses. Rather, we look for symptoms and behaviors that may meet the criteria for these specific diagnoses and will need to be addressed on a treatment plan. After the assessment is complete, a bar graph is created to depict the levels of impairment and give a baseline of where your youth is currently. In 90 days, your youth will receive another CAFAS or PECFAS assessment to to show any changes in impairment over the most recent time period. The graph will then look like this. It will compare the initial assessment to the most recent score your youth received.